We're going to start with Clindel, Lowe, and Angelita Outerbridge. They are counselors up at the CedarBridge Academy, and they're going to be sharing with you information about the difference between merit-based and needs-based scholarships. Most of you are looking for scholarships for your children, and we want to make sure that they're prepared for them. And there are, these are two options that they can take. So Clindel, if you'd like to start, you and Angelita, thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Clindel Lowe. I'm the head of student services at CedarBridge Academy. I do have a slide to share. I'm not sure if I'm able to share it. I will try. Yep, can you see it?
Yes, we can.
Perfect. Okay, so with me this evening is Ms. Angelita Outerbridge. She is our college and career counselor at CedarBridge Academy. And hopefully we have some CedarBridge parents on this evening who are participating, but for all parents, welcome. And we hope that you find the information extremely helpful. So we want to start by explaining to you the difference between a merit-based and a need-based scholarship. So merit-based scholarships are typically awarded on merit or achievement. Most times they are on academic achievement or academic merit, but they can also be based on athletic merit or achievement and or talent merit and achievement. And what we've seen in our career, most of the talent-based scholarships have been visual or performing arts related. So for example, if your child is applying to Berklee School of Music, they may get a scholarship based on their merit, their performance merit, or their talent merit, what we will call it. But most commonly, when we talk about merit-based scholarships, they are academic in nature. And so these scholarship donors or committees are looking to give scholarships to young people based off of their achievement in the academic arena. Some merit-based scholarships also consider financial need, and some merit-based scholarships may be looking for special interests. So I just want to give an example. The last 2 years at CedarBridge Academy, we have seen some of our top students not receive certain scholarships. And it wasn't because of their GPA or their academic achievement, it's because of their interests. And in these cases, we're talking about students who had specific career interests. So we saw a lot of scholarships in the business, international business insurance realm, but some of the students were looking to go into medicine or engineering or other fields of study. So although they met the academic criteria, that special interest category didn't meet the criteria for that. So it's important that when you as parents and students are looking for scholarships, read all of the criteria, okay? Merit-based scholarships can be very competitive. And so the first question I have is, do you meet the criteria? It's very important that students and parents look at what the criteria is for the scholarship. Oftentimes, students will spend a lot of time applying for the scholarship, but they do not meet the criteria. So know what the criteria is. Because merit-based scholarships are competitive, make sure that you submit your application with all of the documents and more. Okay, every applicant is going to have that GPA requirement. Every applicant is going to have their co-curricular or their community service. However, it's very important that you are submitting all of the required documents, but the and more part is important. What's going to make you different from the other applicants? Make sure that your application is error-free. Do not have mistakes. If you are applying for a merit-based scholarship, we are not looking for typos in your essay, for example, typos in your resume or your curriculum vitae. We want to make sure that you are spelling things correctly, that you have read every aspect of your application, and that you are submitting an error-free application. Submit early and on time. Do not wait until the last minute. There are going to be documents and other things that you're going to have to spend time on. And one scholarship to the other, there may be a slight difference in what's required. So make sure you're giving yourself enough time to submit your application early, but make sure that it's on time. Essays matter. Most times, students wait until they do their essays. Do your essays, start essays now. Know what those essay questions are, and make sure that you are putting your all into your essay. So we have a little joke in student services. Sometimes we say, you know, students put their best effort in and they know that this assignment is worth a grade. Well, if you think about your scholarship essay as getting a grade that it's worth 25% of your grade or 30% of your grade, put that type of effort into it, okay? Your essays do matter, and please let someone look over your essays, okay? Have good references. It is fine that you think that you are a great student or you think that your child is a great student, but the scholarship committee wants to know that teachers, community members, they think that your child is a great student, okay? So make sure that you have good references and give it your best effort. Put your everything into your application. Now, how are you gonna stand out? Make sure that you have a support team when you're applying. Student services at any school, your school counselor is a great place to start for parents and for students. If you do not want to reach out to student services, everyone has a favorite teacher. So reach out to that favorite teacher. This year we've partnered with Mirrors to do the PeerForward program. Reach out to Mirrors. If you have someone in your church, your pastor, your Sunday school teacher, your group, youth group leader, have a support system, someone who's going to help you stay on track, okay? Also, what are you involved in? So with merit-based scholarships, everyone, like I said, is gonna have that GPA, they're gonna be a good student, they're gonna have their IGCSEs or AP passes, but what makes you stand out? What else are you involved in? Are you a girl guide? Are you a Boy Scout? Do you do junior leaders? Do you go to church? Have you taught Sunday school? Do you play the violin? What else do you do? So many times students do not think that their other activities are important. And I tell students everything is important, okay? It is a competition. What are your career goals? Talk about what you want to do long-term. What do you want to do? And why do you want to do? Why are you passionate about being an accountant? What difference do you want to make in the world, in Bermuda, long-term? And be prepared for your interview, okay? Have someone practice with you. Have someone ask you tough questions, but you have to be comfortable to not only talk about yourself, but perhaps issues or things that matter to you, okay? Now, needs-based scholarships, they're a little bit different. These scholarships are based off of need. However, some needs-based scholarships do have GPA requirements. Needs-based scholarships, it doesn't matter who you are, what you look like, doesn't matter where you live. It matters though if your parents cannot afford to pay for school themselves. And that's what these scholarship committees are looking at. Over the last few years, we've seen a trend change from tons of merit-based scholarships to more needs-based scholarships. And so for parents and students, if you know you fit into this category, yes, need is important, but so is your academics. So again, there is going to be criteria. The documentation for this type of scholarship is important. We have had students not apply for need-based scholarships in the past because the parents do not want to disclose some financial information. And I would say have a conversation with the school counselor about how you will disclose perhaps what you will disclose, but there is an importance to demonstrate that there is financial need. These financial need forms are handled confidentially. You do not have to share it with anybody else, but essentially what they're looking at in a very simple form is what it is, the income, what your income is, what your expenses are, and is what is left over enough to pay for your child's education. And everyone is going to look different, but at the basic level, that is what is being looked at. Okay. Some parents do not want to disclose everything, and we have had conversations with parents to make them just a little bit more comfortable. But in some instances, need-based scholarships are the way to go. It is the option for some families, but it is nothing to be ashamed of, or it's nothing to kind of shy away from. I'll tell you one quick story. We had a student about 4 years ago who was a good student, well-rounded. She applied for all merit-based scholarships. We also encouraged her and her mom to apply for a few need-based scholarships. And they did not want to. She wanted to just go for, I have a very high GPA, I've done really well. But mom was a single mom, working very hard, and very openly told us, if she doesn't get a scholarship, she cannot go to school. And essentially that's what the scholarship committees want to hear. But that is the difference between a merit-based scholarship where financial need may not be factored in versus a need-based scholarship where there is criteria for GPA. It may not be as high as a merit-based scholarship, but there definitely has to be demonstration of financial need. Okay. All right, so tips, real quick tips that I want to share with you. Seek support. I'm gonna give you two tips. Seek support from a school counselor, a teacher, a mentor, or any adult with some knowledge or experience with completing applications. Even if they've completed an intense job application, that is helpful, because with every job application, you have to submit supporting documents like your resume or references, but have someone support, okay? Number two, make your short list a long list if you can. Many students say, I want this scholarship and that scholarship, but they're eligible for TAN. So why not apply for more? Okay, do not limit yourself to just applying for one or two scholarships. Apply, apply, apply. Many scholarships require similar or the same documentation. I had a student 2 years ago, she applied for 7 scholarships. She was awarded 3 scholarships and had to turn down the 4th offer because she was given so much money in scholarships. But she applied, applied, applied. She put her eggs in all of the baskets. So please make sure that you apply for as many scholarships as possible. Merit-based, need-based, if you meet the criteria, make sure that you apply. So for CedarBridge parents, especially, if you want support, most of you should know that Ms. Outerbridge is doing a series right now with parents and students, helping to support the college application process as well as the scholarship process. But if you need to reach out to us, if you want more in-depth information, if you have any additional questions, feel free to email us or give us a call at the school. This is our email information. And hopefully you found this information about merit-based versus need-based scholarships helpful. Ms. Outerbridge, did you have anything to share or add? She's like my support person.
Sorry. I just wanted to air because I'm sure we have a lot of parents maybe from all different year levels. Of course, students are not going to apply for scholarships until their S4 year, but it's never too soon to begin actually looking at the scholarships, reviewing the scholarships. It may be a good lesson or a good opportunity to just go onto the Bermuda Scholarships website just to have a look through what the scholarships are this year that are being offered. It's great to look through the eligibility requirements just to ensure that your student is on the right track to what's going to be needed at the end in S4. You know, we try to encourage students to stay involved throughout the years in high school, whether it be community service, co-curricular, all those things Mrs. Lowe mentioned about what's going to make the students stand out. So it's important that students are preparing themselves over the years to be eligible for those scholarships. Many times students, you know, look at the criteria at the end of the route when they're ready to apply. And, you know, it's nothing worse than having a student that may not be eligible because of very specific criteria. So just to be prepared in S4 when students are applying, it's good to just over S1, 2, or 3 to just begin looking at what that criteria looks like. Okay, and especially with the merit-based scholarships and the GPA, we often get many students hit S4 and they are doing exceptionally well, but they might have had a bump in S1 or S2 where things were a bit challenging academically, so their GPA may not have been as high as they would have liked. A lot of times students don't realize that GPAs are looked at on a cumulative basis, so the GPA, they have an average GPA on the transcript from every year of high school. So scholarships, when they say they may expect a 2.5, a 3.0, or a 3.5 GPA, they are referring to what we call a cumulative GPA. So that is the average GPA from each year. So, you know, we just want to make sure that students understand the little pieces so that they are putting their best forward, their best foot forward each year, and that they're performing to the best of the ability of their ability so that they are eligible for the scholarships in S4. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Outerbridge, and thank you, Mrs. Lou. Is there anyone who has any questions? You can put them in chat or you can raise your hand now and speak them. No questions? I guess you guys did a great job. You covered all the bases. It was a great presentation, and people know how to reach out to you at CedarBridge Academy. Thank you for your time. Someone said something? The Squire? No? Okay. So thank you for your time, and we're going to move on to our next presenter. Ladies, thank you so much. Go to your PTSA meeting. All righty. We're going to move on to Nikitta Scott. Nikitta Scott is representing the Bermuda College, Nikitta Scott and Cree Watson, and they're going to talk about scholarship options and opportunities at the Bermuda College. But remember, everybody, keep in your mind needs-based and merit-based and what those things mean. Let's go for it.
Okay. Good evening, everyone. I'm going to take a moment to share my screen. And of course, let's see if it works for me a second time.
Nikitta, before you do that, would you properly introduce yourself, please?
I was going to over my cover slide, okay, because I know there may be a delay and now I can't see anyone. So Sandra, if you can let me know whether you can see the actual presentation.
Yes.
Yes, I can. Okay.
So good evening, everyone. I'm Nikitta Scott. I'm the Director for Counseling and Student Activities at Bermuda College. That does include administering financial support services. And I'm joined today by Cree Watson, who's our Intake and Financial Aid Administrator. So it was actually a perfect segue for us to jump in because we do start by talking about our needs-based versus merit-based options. And so I'm going to move on to the next slide. And so you'll see that for Bermuda College, merit-based funding is managed by individual scholarship applications. Those applications are hosted on bermudascholarships.com. And the fund sources for us are definitely private sponsors. So there's different organizations or individuals who've reached out to us with an intent to specifically fund Bermuda College students and programs. As Ms. Lowe mentioned previously, for the majority of our scholarships, the minimum GPA is a 3.0. There are varying citizenship statuses. The majority are Bermudian, but there are some that are looking to support Bermudian or PRC students. Another one of our conditions, and you may need to get used to understanding conditions for scholarship applications, is to be admitted to the college without conditions. What that means for Bermuda College, which is an open admissions college, is that you're being admitted into your program and starting at college level courses. Of course, our students can start at prep courses, but the majority of our scholarship admissions are looking for students who are starting their program with college level courses. In terms of the level of funding for our scholarships, and I have more information on the next slide, but some range from a flat rate per semester to 100% coverage. And when we say 100% coverage, that includes the payment of tuition, fees, and books and relevant supplies. Need-based for us, it's very much need-based. There is a GPA, but it's the GPA that is equivalent to being in good academic standing, and that is a 2.0 GPA or a C average with Bermuda College. Need-based, we tend to refer to them as grants. The fund sources are Bermuda College directly. We now have a foundation, and then we receive a grant from the Bermuda government specifically to provide funding for enrollment in academic courses and courses offered by PACE. And on our need-based, the support tends to range from 30% to 80%. And what I forgot to mention as I started was that if you have questions as we go along, please feel free to stop us or to pop it in the chat. So to take a quick look at our scholarships, at the moment, Bermuda College administers 5 scholarships. We have the Athene Scholarship, and what is not in the notes is we can award up to 10 Athene Scholars each year. And so this is the one that we really push for students who are looking towards business-based programming, and even more so because the scholarship can also come with a work placement or internship. Athene is dedicated to providing full coverage for the duration of the program. And what that means is you can be part-time or full-time. So you're not limited to completing your degree within 2 years. Athene is committed to, as long as you maintain that 3.0, they will continue to fund you until you have managed to graduate from your Bermuda College program. Butterfield and Vallis is one of the few scholarships that is looking for 2.5, and it is specific to our culinary students. So if you're looking to take the diploma in culinary arts or the associate in culinary arts, then Butterfield and Vallis is looking to fund you. They are looking to cover 80% of your costs. And again, that includes your tuition, the lab fees, which for culinary can be quite an extensive additional cost, as well as your books and your supplies. And in this case, supplies include the set of chef knives, your chef uniform, and some other things that you'll need to properly engage with that program. Hamilton Rotary Ted Crawford is our new scholarship. It was launched by the Hamilton Rotary Club 2 years ago. It is specific to students looking to study mathematics or computer information systems. And that's in the name of Ted Crawford, who was a former principal of the Robert Crawford School. So some of you parents may remember that school and his passion and his teaching subjects for mathematics and computer information systems. They provide support for 2 years, and they also fully provide support for supplies, including, if needed, a new laptop. And that's the only scholarship that we have that takes the supplies provision to that level. And we also have one specific for science, and that would be Roche. And if you've been around long enough, it used to be called the Karanj Science Merit Scholarship. Karanj, the company funding Karanj, changed their name to Roche, and so we've renamed the scholarship to reflect their interests. Again, the subject matter for the Roche Scholarship is mathematics, pure science, and since Bermuda College has introduced allied health, it would also be getting students pursuing pre-med, nursing, diagnostic imaging could also apply for this scholarship to seek funding support. And this is full coverage for 2 years. So in this instance, you have 2 years to complete your program with funding. And our final scholarship on offer is Sir William Stevenson. It's a focus in business, and this is the one scholarship we have that is a flat tuition flat support of $2,200 per semester for 2 years. You'll see at the bottom of the slide, we've said all of our scholarships are hosted from BermudaScholarships.com. What I want to stress is the five that I've talked about this evening are the five that are administered specifically by myself and Cree, but there are easily 15 scholarships on BermudaScholarships.com that are specific to Bermuda College. So I would encourage all of you, as you start to do your search, the easiest way to find scholarships specific to Bermuda College is when you log onto the BermudaScholarship.com website, click search, scroll down until you see scholarship name search box, and enter Bermuda College. And that will narrow the results to those scholarships specific to attending Bermuda College. And that includes the Ministry of Education Book Award, which is specific to Bermuda College. It includes a transfer from the tech program that is a dual enrollment program into the any associate degree with Bermuda College. And I believe there's something specific for students that learn differently, all funded by the ministry. But if you're looking for funding and you want to make your search as wide as possible, it is helpful if you're looking to attend Bermuda College to do that wide search so that you understand the 15 different options that could provide funding for you to attend Bermuda College. And with that, I'm going to move to the next slide and turn it over to Cree.
Sorry, I'm just typing in the chat. Ms. Scott, do you mind answering the question in the chat?
Unfortunately, I can't see it, so you'll have to call it out to me.
Okay, I can actually just finish it. Okay, so next I'm gonna be discussing the grant category. So these are normally students that apply for the Bermuda government grant and are technically, we call it funding support fund. So these students that fall under her would be the tuition waiver students. So that would be students from Department of Child and Family Services. Anyone that falls under that umbrella, it's a tuition waiver that covers 100% support for the courses that they're registered for that semester. We also take into consideration the students who apply that are currently unemployed, the students who work part-time or have very limited income within the household, and then the academic courses as well, which would be the courses that fall underneath our associate's degree, diploma, and certification certificate programs, and then we also cover PACE courses as well.
And Cree, can I jump in? So unemployed and underemployed can also refer to the family, the household, because if we're dealing with students coming straight out of high school, the majority of the financial information is going to come from other members of the household. So if it's a mature student, we're looking at their employment status. But if it's a dependent student, then we do look at the household in terms of unemployed, underemployed, and that impact on the income.
Okay, the next slide is going to be the application window for funding support. So applications opens April 1st. That actually falls on a Friday. So Friday, April 1st. The deadline for the scholarship is June 30th. And then the deadline for the funding support application is actually Wednesday, August 24th. So this deadline actually ends the Wednesday before classes actually begin. The November 1st actually is for the spring semester, which will be the January semester. That's when the application window opens, and then December 1st is when it closes.
So now we're gonna take just a deeper look into our funding support application, which is our need-based application.
Okay, so the requirements is that you must be admitted to a Bermuda College program, which means you would have had to put in an application for admission and have been accepted. From there, you'll follow the steps within your letter to make an appointment with your counselor, and then they will discuss with you your program of choice and assist you with choosing your courses for that upcoming semester, whether it's fall or spring. Yes. And then from there, you would complete the online funding support application. So the funding support application is normally, the link is normally found in a few places on our website, but you can also reach out to us as well and we can send you the information to apply. Other documents as requested, if it's an issue with how you completed your form, sometimes we might request additional information in regards to your income or your expenses. We might also, if you're submitting as a waiver student, then you would have to also submit the your letters from Department of Child and Family Services, or if you're a financial assistant, a Bermuda government financial assistant recipient, you would have to submit that letter as well as proof. Okay, the review process. So these are things we consider when we're actually reviewing your application. So for one, the student would obviously have to have a Bermuda College student ID, which they would actually receive when they've submitted an application and been admitted to Bermuda College. You would have to decide how you're going to apply, if the student will apply as an independent or dependent applicant. And you also have to know the program of choice that they're applying for. In regards to the semester education course, this part would actually come after the registration process. So if you take a look in our, I actually don't have one right in hand, but in our Bermuda College catalog, which is normally found online on the Bermuda College website, it's normally found in the front. I don't know if I put it up, can you see it? No, it's gonna blur it. Okay, so it's actually normally found in the front of the book, but it has the education course depending on the amount of credits that the student is registered for. And then if it's any layup fees attached, which is normally so like culinary or technical education, if it's any layup fees attached to that particular course, this would also be factored in as well. We also consider the annual household income. So that means all the salaries, pensions, or any income coming into the household. Expenses, this would be everything that falls under, anything that's paid out per month. So rent, mortgage, electricity, anything, utilities, that's all the expenses. The monthly household balance, that's the annual, that's the monthly income minus the monthly expenses. So that'll be your balance and how much you have left over. And we can see, kind of make a rough judgment of how much you can afford to contribute towards the education course. And then we also use our financial support rubric, which it's a rubric that we use that displays the medium household income. And we use that depending on the amount of persons within the household. And then we also factor in everything else to see how much they're actually approved for, anywhere from 30 to 80%.
Thank you, Cree. Just to give you an overview from Bermuda College funding support, our funding cycle runs according to our fiscal year, so April 1st to March 31st. And so last year, we were able to support 340 students, and that became approximately $665,000 dispersed to ensure that our students had some level of support for completing our program. The reason we focused on funding support and the need-based funding is because 90% of our students are receiving support from our need-based grant awards. Well, 10% at this point are receiving support from our merit-based funding. And some of that is just the volume of funds we're receiving currently from Bermuda government and the Bermuda College Foundation to provide need-based funding.
Is it possible you can make the slides larger? I'm actually having trouble seeing the writing on the slides.
I can try. Are you seeing
the screen? Is it at the top? Maybe the display settings at the top?
So that's what you're seeing? You're seeing the display settings in the end slide?
Yes.
That's unfortunate. Okay. And this is what happens when you do presentations with a dual screen display. I've lost it. Wonderful. Apologies, guys. Let me. And of course, it didn't do that when I, and this is not the presentation that I want. Give me. One second to try and get back into that.
While Nikitta is working on that, Cree, could you answer this question? Tell me a little bit about the College Promise Scholarship. Does that come under you guys or does it come through the ministry?
It actually comes from the ministry. So I believe it's any student that has a 3.0 GPA. It does not cover books, but it does cover the Bermuda College education course, which would be the tuition and fees.
Okay. And with the tuition waiver, it's really focused for people underemployed, unemployed, or on financial assistance, even if they are employed?
So the waiver is actually it's actually for students that fall under the Department of Child and Family Services. Okay. So that can be if they're in residential care or any of the facilities as well. Okay. But it's mainly for students that fall under the Department of Child and Family Services.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Is there a difference between the scholarships and the grants?
So for the scholarships is actually, they cover like what Ms. Scott discuss, they're actually specific to whether it's GPA or the certain amount that they are receiving. The grant that we actually receive, those are private funds that we disperse. So we give anywhere from 30 to 80% support depending on need. But like those students that come from Department of Child and Family Services and everything, they have to do regular application process, like someone that would be applying for funding support. So it's not a completely different application.
Yeah. Is there a cost for the application?
No, there isn't. And the application is normally available online. I know it's, they put it a few different places on the Bermuda College website, but you can always give us a call and we can either email it to you or we can walk you through on how to access it from the Bermuda College website.
Nikitta, rather than looking for your slide, if you would just want to go ahead and talk about it and not look at the slides, we're good.
Okay. There were only two slides left, but part of it
left to right.
Sorry. Can you hear
me? Yeah, there were only two slides left.
Yes. But the last slide had our contact information, but what I can do
you can type it.
Create it as a PDF to send to you, Sandra. So you can send it out to the participants.
In the chat.
But the last slide.
Yeah, I'll type it in the chat.
Yes. So we had ended with our kind of a look at our funding from last year. And again, 90% of the funding came from need-based funding. If you consider the current student population at Bermuda College, we're probably supporting just under 50% of our students. Through our department with the funding that we've received. And the final slide, which would have been helpful to have a visual, was looking at the value of Bermuda College as your students look to transfer. So at the moment, on average, completing a two-year program at Bermuda College is going to cost about $10,000, excluding books. And so a little bit of research looking at the average cost for the US. If you were going directly from high school to a public university in the US, you were looking at paying $100,000 for 4 years. And if you were looking at private, on average, you were looking at paying $180,000 for 4 years. And again, I'm stressing average because it could be lower, but it could also be higher. If you factor in taking 2 years at Bermuda College, which is going to cost you $10,000, then you're looking at $60,000 for 4 years if you're looking to go to a public institution. $10,000 at Bermuda College, on average $50,000 for the remaining 2 years of your bachelor's degree. And from the private sector, again, it's looking like $100,000, $10,000 to finish Bermuda College, and $90,000 to finish that private sector. That's the U.S. as an international student. U.S. and international in Canada, you're looking, and I'm probably going to get this wrong, but I want to say you're looking at $50,000 or $60,000 if you attend Bermuda College versus $120,000 if you don't attend Bermuda College. And so that's kind of another value proposition as you look at your finances and you understand where do you want to focus securing the funding for the next step. I can share that Bermuda College is continuing to receive interest from organizations who are looking to fund the next steps, but at the moment, those are two or three schools. And so, and we have far more students and applicants than the two or three colleges that or organizations that are offering not just funding for Bermuda College, but funding for the next step. And at the moment, everyone who's kind of in that bucket is for business students. So what I will say is, do we know how much? I just saw a question pop up regarding the value of the college promise. I would want to verify this. The College Promise is actually managed by the Office of our Vice President, Academic and Student Affairs, but I believe the value is $5,000 per year for 2 years. And so students who are taking longer to move for their program can become ineligible for continued funding if they've maxed the amount of funding they receive. And the reality is some of our students do take longer than 2 years to finish the program, some because they have to work, and it's helpful to be full-time, part-time to get the grades that they want, and some do have to start with prep courses. The UK is becoming a case-by-case basis. There was a time when we qualified for home fees, and then government changed in the UK, and home fees became a different story in the UK, where universities were allowed to change the tuition rates for their students. So the UK for Bermuda and Bermuda College specifically is always going to be a case-by-case basis. That's from the transfer process as well as how much it's going to cost. It would be very difficult for us to give you a flat answer for that because schools are having different latitudes on what they can charge. My recommendation, if you have anyone looking for the UK, is to start that conversation early, if you're in high school, definitely at the S4 level. And if you've already graduated or you feel like it's too late, because quite frankly, if you were looking to be in the UK for September, you should have already applied. We have a counselor on staff, Lyndon Jackson, who we consider our specialist in kind of that UK transfer process. And he would be happy to meet with anyone in terms of discussing that process, because it is very much a case-by-case basis. Even as a transfer student, we have to have one-on-one conversations with the school about how they will view Bermuda College. So you may have heard advertisements about us creating our one-year diploma for the UK transfer. It's still helpful to have a conversation with the school about what courses they'd like to see that student take at Bermuda College so that we can craft it, customize it to support that transfer. And I would love to drop the slide deck in there, but the one I was actually using seems to have gone among the missing, and it's actually in my Office Live account, which means I'd have to try and get into it before you guys close, and I'm happy to do that so that you'd have the link to it. Or again, I can get it out to Sandra, who hopefully can get it out to all of you. I just want to make sure I didn't miss. So So I see a question. My son doesn't have his status yet in terms of Bermuda status, will apply when he turns 18. We actually had to deal with that situation this semester where a student was applying for need-based funding, and we encouraged them to submit the application so he wouldn't miss the deadline and we would hold it. And thankfully, he received his status communication from government, I want to say on August 18th. And so we were able to process him for funding for the fall semester and have continued to cover him for the spring semester. So as much as we said, please don't submit that application until you have all the information on a case-by-case basis. If you reach out to us and share the circumstances with us, we will encourage you to submit, but let you know that we're putting it in hold until we can verify all of the information. So in terms of on the scholarship website, we're currently updating our requirements. So one of the things is proof of status, but we actually use our student information system to verify that. So if you're applying for multiple scholarships, you may have already uploaded this document, and it's fine to give Bermuda College access to that, but that's something we tend to use our system to verify, because students have to submit that type of documentation during the admission process. And I think I've covered.
Thank you, Nikitta. You have covered a lot, and Cree, great job covering what's available at the Bermuda College. And I hope that everybody has enough information to help make some decisions. And you do have the contact information for Cree and Nikitta in the chat, or you can call directly up to the Bermuda College and they can support you if you have any further questions. Great information. Sounds like a great opportunity to save some money, people.
So, Sandra, out of curiosity, you're keeping this open for an open Q&A, or are you closing
At the end, yes, yes.
Because what I'll do then is I will work to get a PDF up into this chat. Okay. In terms of the slides.
Great. We're going to be on until 7:30.
Okay.
And if anyone has any questions in between, please put it in the chat and we will acknowledge you. But we're going to move on to Ms. Catherine Fubler right now. And it's a family. Her son, Nathan, and they're going to talk about their experience around scholarship applications and where they ended up. So I'm not going to use up your time. Let's let Ms. Fubler start, and you can introduce your son, Ms. Fubler. Unmute yourself and start.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Catherine Fubler, and unfortunately, my son, Nathaniel, like I spoke to Ms. Dill, may not be available tonight because it is audit season. So he is still stuck at Deloitte working. So about his scholarships and how he went through school, I can do something about that and let everybody know how it went. First of all, with Nathaniel, he actually graduated high school a year early. So he only did 3 years of high school. And then he went up to Bermuda College and he enrolled in the business program with actuarial science. That was his passion. As he came to a close with that, he did realize that Georgia State University was in alignment with Bermuda College or whatever the word is. And so that was the university he wanted to go to. He didn't choose any other, that was it. He was stuck on Georgia State and he did end up there. He enjoyed his time there. He graduated in December 2020. Now back to the scholarships. I thought it was kind of crazy. He came home one day from Bermuda College and he said to me, I had my interview today. I was like, what interview? It's like, oh, for the scholarship. I was like, okay, well, I hope you did all right. Then he turned around the next day, called me and said, I got the scholarship. I was like, there's no way you had an interview today, yesterday, and got a scholarship today. That's impossible. He's like, no, it's not. I have the scholarship. So I was over the moon for that. It was the actual Chubb scholarship for Bermuda College students in a business program. But that wouldn't be enough. I was a single mother. And let me think. When he left school, how many kids did I still have at home? Six. Yeah, six. So he knew he would have to put the work in and apply for others. But he knew which ones he wanted to apply for, being the program that he wanted to enroll in and continue was actuarial science. So he did apply for all of the big four scholarships, which is EY, all those big ones, Chubb, and the four of them. And he was able to get Deloitte. So that meant then that if he had received another one, he would have to decline it. But he didn't have to decline the Chubb scholarship from Bermuda College, because that was specific to a Bermuda College student. It wasn't their main scholarship. So then that was two scholarships. We're still like, it's not enough. So he applied for ABIC scholarships, and he did receive the one under the anonymous donor. So we don't know who that was. But that one worked out to be a blessing in disguise, because I said Nathaniel graduated not in May of 2020, but in December of 2020, which meant he had an added on semester. Deloitte wouldn't pay for it. His scholarship was up. And so we had a discussion, and I said, well, maybe some of your siblings will help if it falls through. But let's see. Can you talk to the scholarship that came under anonymous, the person that handles all of the scholarships through ABIC? And he did. And the person agreed, because I guess, I don't know what they looked at, but I think it really was his grades as well as his merit, and that he had done so well, that they agreed to pay for that last semester. So that enabled Nathaniel to complete his dream, if I could put it that way, of, you know, going into actuarial science. And now he's got to look forward to all the other exams before he is an actual actuary.
Well, congratulations. It sounds like you put quite a bit of effort into making this happen. And I'm sure with your support, although it sounds like he just went and did it and told you, huh?
Well, that's how it went. But I have, well, he's not the oldest. So I have older children that had gone through applying for scholarships. And I've seen the gamut run very differently. My eldest daughter actually won a scholarship to attend Bermuda College. She went for one semester and she was like, this is not for me. So then we had to pay the scholarship back, which we did. And she had been seconded to a job that said that, you know, they would, she would work as well as do online schooling and stuff like that. So she ended up, that's why she decided to forego Bermuda College. And then I have another child that's older than Nathaniel. He went to Bermuda College from high school. And that was right when I became a single parent. And he had a job at an international company in Bermuda. Although he was still in high school, he had a job there. And he told them that he wasn't going to go away to university. He would go through the MSVU program for business administration at Bermuda College. So the first 2 years are totally administered by Bermuda College. And then you go through having the online classes with MSVU. And he got, he did get an ABIC scholarship for Bermuda College. And he got a BFIS scholarship for Bermuda College. And then his company paid for his final year of university, after he submitted all his grades and everything. So he never got a scholarship to attend MSVU. He paid that out of pocket from work. And just to let you all know, no, he wasn't making this wonderful wage. He was actually still being paid a student wage because he had the time off to attend college. He had the time off to get home in time for his online classes in the evening. But they did pay for his last year of university. So things can work out in ways that maybe we never think about as parents. And so what's actually helped with like Nathaniel and my younger ones, like Jamin is away right now. they have their older siblings that would send them messages in their WhatsApp sibling chat. Did you see this scholarship? Did you see that one? Do you think this is one you need? And so they have a lot of support from each other. And then I'm like the last person to find out that, oh, you actually did apply for it.
Great. So, and I think that's, thank you. I think it's important that it takes a village, and you're using your village to make this happen for your young people. Now we have another family on, Victoria Outerbridge and Chrissy Outerbridge, and they're gonna share their experiences regarding the whole scholarship process. So ladies, you can start. Just introduce yourself and you can move on.
Good evening, everyone. I am Victoria Outerbridge. I don't know if you can hear me or see me. Can you? Yes.
We can hear and see you, Vicki.
Okay. I actually do work at CedarBridge Academy, so some of you may know my name from that. I've had two daughters go through CedarBridge and go off to higher education. And for the most part, my youngest daughter, I would say, was fortunate that she got a few scholarships, which helped immensely. And she had made a decision. She had went off to Georgia State. She made a decision to change her program. So she did come back home and she did go to the Bermuda College for one semester before going off to the UK to study pharmacy. And I know at that point I told her, you know, money is tight. While we were her, she had both our parents, but you know, money was tight and we still had to watch our pennies. I said, you will need scholarships to help you. So encouraged her to apply, and she was fortunate to get a scholarship through Knowledge Quest. And she also got this scholarship from Phoenix Pharmacy, which helped for 4 years. And while it was not enough to cover everything, it did help. And the rest, I basically for out of pocket, either through getting an educational loan to help. I've also had to take some money out of my pension. There are ways for to assist. But at the end of the day, I can say while it was a struggle, we still managed to get through, made sure we had what we needed. And I was happy to know that once they both finished, we didn't have any educational debt. I'll let my oldest daughter, Chrissy, tell you her journey. but that's all I can say.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Christina. I graduated from Bermuda College 2013, so it is a while ago. My educational journey wasn't linear. So when I left high school, I ended up going to United World College program. I primarily took that opportunity for two reasons. I definitely wanted the opportunity. I wanted something a little different. I didn't feel I was ready for college yet, but I did know that they were offering a scholarship. I knew that they were going to be providing a good sizable amount that would help their students. And I had always been conscious that I would need support for continuing my higher education. And when I won that scholarship or won that opportunity, I definitely took that. I ended up doing the IB, and that set me up then for some of my later educational goals, per se. So it helped me get into a university that I wanted to go to that was in Canada. And as Ms. Scott had mentioned, the Canadian international fees can be quite pricey. And I was looking at, for my first year, about $30,000. I ended up not finishing, and I came back to Bermuda to kind of reassess, to get my footing. And I figured, okay, well, I'll go to the Bermuda College. During my time when I went there, we had the GPA, I think, like 50% off for your GPA. And based on my high school grades, I was able to get 50% off my tuition. At this time, I was also working. So as my mom mentioned, I had a younger sibling. I was very conscientious to kind of take on as much of the financial requirements as I could while I was trying to continue my education. So I was working part-time and going to school at Bermuda College part-time. And based on those opportunities, with it being half of my tuition, I was able to have a zero balance and manage all of my fees. I then looked at scholarships to help me as I was going on to my bachelor's. I ended up going to the UK. I was able to apply to Bermuda College specific scholarships. I ended up getting the president's scholarship that was offered to Bermuda College students. Some of the tips I would give to students and parents out there going through this process, as I mentioned before, apply for as many as you can that you are eligible for. Don't forget the small ones. Later on in some of my other years when I was looking at other scholarships, because I'm still a student, I'm currently trying to get my PhD online, and it's constantly, you know, working and school for me, but those little ones add up. And you know, some people have mentioned that you have to kind of give back money if you've gotten some of those larger ones, but you can take a lot more of the smaller ones, say if you get those. So that's an opportunity to look at. I would also say pay close attention to the requirements. I know other people have mentioned those points. Maybe speak to some other people that you know that have won these awards or have gone through that process to maybe get an inside track to see what maybe those committees or those boards are looking for specifically. And the essay matters. It's about balancing that personal perspective, you know, showing yourself on that paper while also balancing the points that they're looking for. You know, we mentioned the differences between needs-based and merit-based, but, you know, highlighting what they're wanting while also showing yourself in that. I think the scholarship and application process can be a very personable experience, and it kind of can be a little raw, but, you know, it's going through that process, I think, is quite rewarding. You know, when you're picked to go through the interviews and try to see if they'll help you out in your next stages. And I just encourage everyone going through this process. I'm going through it still myself. So yeah.
Thank you. Does anyone have any questions for either Vicky or Chrissy? I just want to speak to Chrissy's journey. It was not a typical journey where she started out and she kept going, mm-hmm. and she finished in the same place she started. She is actually a CedarBridge graduate. I know that. Then she went on to the Bermuda College. Then she went to did some IB work overseas, and then she came back and went to Canada, and then came back to the Bermuda College, and then went back again. That is not a typical journey, but it's a journey that took her where she wants to be. She has now earned her undergrad degree, a master's degree, is currently working in a government department, mm-hmm. and is working on a PhD. So all of that costs money. And as her mom said, it's a two-parent family, but doesn't mean that they got a whole bunch of cash stashed up. So Chrissy's journey around, even she talked about working, helping to support the family so that her younger sister could go. I want people to pay attention to this journey. It's not a straightforward process for everybody. One of the reasons I wanted Chrissy to talk about this is to talk so that people could understand. If you have stops along the way and gaps along the way and have to change the pathway, do it. You can still get there. Anything else that anyone else would like to share? Any questions for anyone?
Sandra, if you permit me, I want to apologize for the disruption in the college presentation. Unfortunately for us, we have to work in two systems when we operate in Zoom. And so some things did get lost, including you seeing the wrong screen, but I have managed to upload the PDF to the chat. So if you can grab it before you exit tonight, it does have our contact information, and we are open and available to ask questions at any point in time. So you'll have an email contact for us as well as a link that allows you to schedule appointments with us. And at the moment we're doing virtual appointments only. Hopefully in the next couple of months we'll be open to face-to-face as well. But just wanted to let you know that it has been uploaded to the chat so that you can look through it in your own time.
Yes, thank you. We saw it in the chat. Thank you so much for sharing that, Nikitta. And I think even with that uploaded in the chat, there's enough information on the PowerPoint where people look at it and start to make some decisions. Thank you. Is there anyone else you'd like to share?
Can you, Nikitta, can you speak to if it's a rule, if you don't finish, you have to pay Bermuda College grant back?
Absolutely not. Our grants do not need to be repaid. There's not a requirement that you finish your program. In fact, Cree and I spent a lot of work today because we got notifications from the business office that for whatever reason, people had to withdraw from classes today or this week. And we do void the grant, but at this point in time, there's no billing to the student once we voided that grant. So there is no expectation for the Bermuda College administered grants that students have to repay them if they don't finish. In terms of our grants, there are, it's something that our students have to apply for every year. And so if you decide to stop out this semester for whatever reason, there is an opportunity to come on board again in the fall semester. To be clear, if you've applied for the fall funding, you are now covered for the year. So if you applied and were approved for fall funding, you're automatically approved for the spring semester. So when we say it opens for the spring semester, it's for those students who missed the fall application period. But as you heard Christina's story, not just Bermuda College, but community colleges around the world are designed to work with students who have unusual journeys. And part of that is stopping in and stopping out. And so there's an expectation that for whatever reason, students may have to stop out, whether it's at the end of a successful semester. But for our grants, I can't speak for all that may show up on BermudaScholarships.com, but for the grants administered by Bermuda College, there's no expectation that you repay.
Thank you. Another question is in the chat. Is there any scholarship or financial help for children on the special needs challenges spectrum?
Not administered directly by Bermuda College, but the Ministry of Education does facilitate one. And there's another, and I'm going to forget the name of the organization, but there is an organization that facilitates funding for students with special challenges. So again, BermudaScholarships.com, both are on BermudaScholarships.com. So it is worth wherever your student is in their process, becoming familiar with that website, shortlisting some options that you think are specific to you so that you're always prepared for the submission of an application. So there are at least two that I'm aware of, and one is offered by the Ministry of Education.
Thank you. Anyone else would like to share anything? Okay, so we have two things that have to happen. One, we have a prize that I didn't give out at the beginning, but I'm giving it out now. And I'm going to choose someone. Dion Wilson, you are the winner of a $50 gift certificate at Brown & Co. So stop by the Mirror's office on Friday, by Friday at 3 o'clock to collect Dion Wilson. The second thing is we have a survey for you to do, and it is in the chat. So if you would, everybody, we're going to give you 3 to 5 minutes. We're going to put on some background music for you to complete that survey. It's important that we have that information because we want to know what value we're bringing to our community as we go through this process. So we're going to put on some background music. Everyone click on the chat. There are 61 applicants, and I want a big number for the number of completions. So let's take some time and do that. If you don't have access, just hit me up in the chat and say, I can't see it. We're gonna cue up some music for you. Some money, money, money. Music.
Okay, we need you to complete the survey. I don't see any completed yet. Okay, we've got 17 in. 17 completed. We are up to 25.
You can do it. You can do it. Let's do it, people.
Okay, we are almost there. We are at 40.
Mr. Martin wants more music.
Okay, okay. My music. Sandra, as we close out, do you have any tips for parents and students here about our personal statement?
Yes.
That's one of the key parts of the scholarship application.
Yes. So we have a couple of tips before we close out. I just wanted to make sure we had enough surveys done before we wrapped up. A couple of things that showed up in tonight's conversation was one about the personal statement. Very important. We're going to be running some workshops this summer for students coming forward on how to create that personal statement that wins you the money or gets you into the university. It's a real technique to making this happen. We're going to have each of the high schools is doing a whole session presentation on interview skills, getting in front of that interview committee, people you are applying for scholarships. You've got to wrap it up. You got to seal the deal. You seal the deal with the interview for many of the applications. So don't forget to seal the deal. As you're applying for your scholarships, make sure that you complete every section. Parents, there's one part that you have to do. There's only one part that you have to do as a parent, and that is the financial need part. You can download it, you can complete it on the BermudaScholarships.com website. You have to fill that information. Now, I'm going to say this. We have, many of us have been to the bank to borrow money for a car or a mortgage, Lord bless us, and they ask you all your business. Well, you know what? Your child going to university is another big investment. We're talking easy $30,000 a year. If they're leaving the island. That's the minimum amount, because we're talking about tuition, books, airline, room and board. On the low end. On the high end, we're talking about $60,000. It's not just 1 year, it's every year. Many of your young people will get scholarships, but they may only be for a year or two. Remember, if you have to apply the second year, complete the application again. Some of the scholarships, big tip, some scholarship providers will say they will give you a four-year scholarship, but at the end of each year, you have to submit your transcript. If you don't submit your transcript, you lose the scholarship. So those are tips to keep in mind when you're applying, when you get them, how to keep them. The last tip is your journey can be whatever it is. Like Chris's journey, you can start here, go there, come back here, but you can't stop, people. You can't stop. The whole purpose of this education is so that you can afford the lifestyle that you want. So focus on senior scholarship. Someone's in the chat saying Nikita's presentation, it's there. So she just put it up again. I've also saved it and downloaded it, and I can forward it out later. But it is right there. Just hit the download, the little blue button, and you can access it. Now, we're going to win another $50. But before you do that, guess what? We're going to talk about next week's presentation. So this is a five-week series. So we've done, this is the second week. Next week, the Department of Workforce Development is going to come on. They're going to talk about scholarships and funding for the trades and vocational education. So they're going to talk about what they provide, training, funding, support, whatever it is they do. So please log on and find out what they have to offer. Again, we're going to have the parents and students talk about their experience, because in the last survey, that's what we found. People really enjoyed that part and got a lot out of that section. So join us next week, same time, same channel, same login. A couple of you sent me WhatsApps or notes to say, I can't find the link. Same one you had this week, you have next week, same login. So stay in contact, share the information with your friends. If you think it's good stuff, share it. We want our whole community. Our goal is that everybody in our community has access to education. Bermuda College is a great place to start, and it's cost efficient. Get started, people. Start your journey. So, are you ready for the $50 gift certificate? Are you ready? Are you ready?
And the first person to put the answer in the chat wins.
Yes. Right. So you have to type it in. Don't say it. You have to type it in. Do my drum roll again. Okay. First person, name two types of merit-based scholarships. It was said way at the front of the program. Two types. I only see one, Ms. Lisa Talbot. I only see one. Everybody, if you put it in, you gotta put both of them in at the same time. I see people are putting in one. I want you to put in both.
Trina put in academic and athletic.
Who did that? Oh, Trina, you are the winner. Mm-hmm. You are the winner, Trina. Yes, academic, yes, and athletic. Those are two types of merit-based scholarships. Gotcha. You win. Thank you all for coming. I hope that you got something important that you can use from this session. Share it with your friends, and we'll see you again next week. If you have anything that you need to know, give us a call and we will try and help you up. Call Bermuda College and they can help you as well. Have a great evening. Thanks for tuning in.